Security was tight at the Monarch Gala. You took quite a risk walking into the lion's den.
If we were gonna kidnap Dr. Amaral, then we needed to do it from the inside.
Beth Wilder, you were quick to trust her.
We had common interests.
Is that all you had?
It's all we needed.
Thanks for showing up.
Here, I thought this was gonna be a rescue. Yeah, there's a story here.
You know a guy called Hatch?
Serene's right-hand man.
He was here. He gave me this big speech about how he wants to take down Paul.
I hope you said no.
I didn't trust him for a second. He set me loose anyways, told me to wait for an opening.
I just gave you one.
Appreciate it. What's it look like out there?
I think you're secure. Everyone's concentrating on the party. So far, your crazy plan's working.
And Dr. Amaral?
I don't have a fix on her. She's either at the party or at her office at the R&D facility here on the island. I'll scout out the party.
So you're gonna sip champagne while I break into a high-security installation? It's like you got this all figured out.
I'll save you a cocktail, weenie.
Oh, well, in that case...
My cover isn't gonna survive the night, but it'll last a little longer, so you can't walk out the front door with me. This is the quickest way to the R&D facility. I disabled the security at the back door, but there'll be guards. Contact me when you're clear. And Jack, you know what's at stake here. This can't be about revenge.
I'm not here for Paul. Do this.
Hey, he's escaping.
That will hurt in the morning.
My powers were growing. I was learning to control them better. That felt good.
Who the hell designs these doors? Okay, I'm gonna have to move faster to get through. Very sci-fi and very Monarch. Something tells me it wasn't commissioned by them, though. Hey, Beth, I'm clear. What's next?
You'll see a radar tower up ahead soon. Let me know when you get inside.
All right. Warn me about that one, Beth. Okay, how am I getting to that radar tower? Up you go. Let's try this again. Come on, too slow, Jack. All right, that's it.
Turned into a mess. It's all supposed to be quietly swept under the carpet. But now we've got a shitload more bodies to disappear.
Well, at least we got it under control now.
Time felt broken here. The whole canon felt unstuck in time. The timeline of the old canon felt loose. I could shift it around.
Smart place to aim the cannon, guys.
I've been thinking. Monarch projections say these stutters are getting more frequent. If one hits while we're grabbing Dr. Amaral...
You'll be frozen. Yeah, I know. It's a risk.
Monarch specialist troopers have the stutter-proof gear. I bet Dr. Amaral would have that in her office, too.
I'll keep an eye out. See if I grab it for you.
It's dangerous.
Frank!
Thanks, Beth. Need to get to the radar tower. Okay. Next stop, the radar tower. Beth? I'm at the radar tower. Where's the lab?
Below your feet. It's all top secret. The elevator inside will take you down.
Whoa, seriously? What is this, a Bond villain lair?
You have no idea. Just don't fall into the shark tank.
Fuck.
Good evening, folks. This is your pal, Bobby Radford, and you better believe I'm still hopping mad about what went down at the university last night. But I got nothing new on that. Getting stonewalled. So let me take another approach. You know how Monarch took over the old dry docks, what, 5, 6 years back? Just bought it all up and set up some kind of an industrial operation there or something? Well, it turns out they had a freak accident there this morning. One of those unfinished ships came crashing down. You probably heard all about it. It was pretty spectacular. You'd think there'd be some kind of explanation for what had to be a multi-million dollar disaster. But guess which multinational corporation has no comment on that little event either. Now, I don't know about you folks, but it seems to me all of a sudden there's a lot of weird stuff going down and Monarch's name just keeps coming up. So what's Monarch doing about it? It's business as usual for them. In fact, they're throwing a party at their fancy mansion on Gull Island. From what I hear, it's gonna be a hell of a bash. But of course, it's off limits to anybody who isn't a part of their clique. Kinda seems to me these guys bought out Riverport. And now, they're getting drunk while the city burns. But I'm sure they've got our best interests in mind, huh?
Legion. For years, we have been building towards this day. Years of planning, developing,
speech is streaming.
Training.
Let's give Monarch the audience they deserve.
The end of a 17-year journey, and today we emerge from the shadows. We do so accepting great responsibility. I present to you the CFR, the Cronon Field Regulator. This device has been at the heart of our Cronon research since 2010, but I am here to assure you that it is so much more than just that. This device will be our salvation, and as promised, it is ready. To some of you, this means nothing. To others, everything. Rest assured, you will all know when the time is right. We are entering a volatile age. Great danger is coming our way. It cannot be prevented, but we can be protected. And so tonight is a celebration. A celebration in the face of darkness. We celebrate, but for some of you, this means nothing. For others, everything. Rest assured, you will all know when the time is right. We are entering a volatile age. Great danger is coming our way. It cannot be prevented, but we can be protected. And so tonight is a celebration in face of darkness. Tonight we celebrate because I promise to you that we are prepared. We are prepared for what comes next. We are prepared to do what is necessary. We are prepared to survive. Thank you.
Look at him. Not a care in the world. Beth, I'm about to take the elevator. I see Paul's still fond of his own voice.
Yeah, he's talking about his survival plan. Crowd's eating it up.
Dr. Amaral's office. Looks like that's one level up. What is that? It's like I'm being drained.
The device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a chronon dampener.
I've adjusted the flight controls so the drone will crash into the villa in order.
There it is. I'll make sure that Sophia is in position when the time is right. Wait for my call.
Here.
Okay, I gotta get to Dr. Amaral's office.
Serene ordered Hatch to kill me because he didn't want to put his plan at risk. But seeing the scale of that facility, I started realizing just how deep that plan went. It made me wonder, if time was ending, what was it all for? The alarm would trigger as soon as the stutter broke. I was on borrowed time.
Dr. Amaral's office. Looks like that's one level up.
Yeah.
Which way is Amron's office?
These things were designed like walking tanks.
They weren't for you. Don't flatter yourself.
Be able to get out from here. Try that again. Guessing this isn't the usual employee route. Dr. Amaral's office must be close. No alarms. Looks like nobody here knows about the mess I made on the way in. Nice job, Beth.
Now, look. It's just math. The more people, the bigger the area we need to prove. And the less time we're gonna have. Literally.
Guns made to operate in a stutter. Paul had clear priorities. When time ends, guns don't. There we go. It was technology that allowed people to move inside a stutter.
But too heavy to carry, I assume.
That's why I had to find the lighter model. In Amaral's office. I knew I couldn't leave the offices before locating Dr. Amaral. Come on, you're at work.
garage. Sounds like the way out of this place.
All I had to do was make it through the garage. Seems simple enough.
What are they gonna do to that Burke guy? After what he pulled, you gotta figure he's dead, right?
HQ, contact, over.
Copy.
Alarm's not gonna make my life any easier. There's gotta be a way out of here. Damn. The alarm must have locked everything down. Maybe I can turn it off. God. That's what I'm talking about.
Adventures in Flesh by L. Hakola. Chapter 11.
Is somebody playing an audiobook
when
over the radio?
Finally,
whoever that is, shut it off now.
His dungeon.
I think I'll just leave that right there.
Somebody find out where that's coming from. This is supposed to be a secure channel.
He was still dressed in his impeccable suit of softest velvet, wearing the horn-rimmed glasses that gave him an air of indisputable authority. Behind those glasses were his eyes, and those eyes glinted with feverish anticipation. I squirmed in my sprints. "So," he said, "here we are. You're gagged and helpless, and I can't wait to send my adventurer party into the darkest dungeon, located in the soft, damp underbelly of your citadel." He paused and licked his thin lips. "And I brought along my 10-foot pole." I squirmed again. He laughed long and hard. "Oh, yes. I'll take out the battering ram, my pretty. Whatever it takes to smash my way into your sanctum sanctorum." He must have caught something on my face then. He adjusted his glasses and cleared his throat. "Look, not to break the scene, but please nod if you're still into this. I mean, just to be sure. I don't want there to be any... I mean, we're not idiots here, right? Fantasy's great, but, you know, explicit consent's the secret sauce, right?" He giggled sensually. I stayed very, very still. Then I nodded. His face broke into a devilish grin. "Well," he said, as he pulled on the leather gloves and picked up the oversized D20.
"Beth, I got that device for you, but Dr. Amaral's at the party."
"Yeah, I just spotted her. Wanna be my date?"
"Yeah, save me that cocktail, weenie. I'll make my way there."
"Serene's finished his speech and he knows you're loose. He's headed your way. Remember what we said. I'll keep him occupied, but switch to the Monarch frequency to make sure you stay out of his crosshairs."
"Okay, I'll see you at the party."
Catch this!